I've even got a, I'll keep this right here. So whatever happens, we're gonna be fine.
I am trying to collect $2,600, trying to get my money back from Miss Aricia for some bad candles that was purchased from her through my business.
Excuse me, Your Honor, I would like to interject here. I kind of feel like all my candles, I make them from home. I use all organic oils. I've never had any other complaints about my candles on my website. A lot of my customers love my candles. A lot of my things are sold out. I'm not understanding that.
The wick was falling to the side. The candles were not staying lit. I had to, like, literally keep relighting them, as well as I had to use more.
The wick couldn't stand up? The wick kept...
Not at all, Your Honor. I do have... let me present...
I understand that, yeah.
I have a picture, actually, Your Honor, of the actual candle. I'm not a candle expert, but I know the candle wicks are not supposed to sit to the side. That is evidence B.
Well,
you'll see that the wick, it's slanted, and the candle kept, like, making it go out.
I actually mailed you some candles to your courtroom, if you could, so you can kind of get...
Oh, that is what... I was wondering, because I have all the... Najee, we're very safe here in this courtroom. Najee, other than being the bailiff, among other things, he is a New York City firefighter. And so we're going to have full protection here. Najee, if you will bring the candle over, and not only do we have Najee here to make sure that no fires break out... I've even got a... I'll keep this right here. So whatever happens, we're going to be fine. If I burn up, hey, remember, I really liked you guys. Okay, here comes Najee carrying the flame. And there you go. And, yeah.
And also, Judge, I have very good candles. They won't set anything on fire.
The wick is hanging in there. So far, the wick is good.
The candles that she sent me... Initially, they were great. I'm definitely not trying to down talk her business. The samples she sent me were great. However, the 250 that she sent me were not what she initially gave me in a sample. I'm not certain if she changed the recipe or did something different or added something different, but she definitely does have a great product. However, what she sent me was not what was not the good product.
So recently, she asked me to make 250 candles for her event. I told her I would do it. Now, mind you, Jerry, I'm doing all my own candle making, shipping. I do my own web design and everything. I do everything by myself. So sometimes it's overwhelming when I'm making candles because I'm doing everything by myself. And I made 250 candles for her event. She told me that when she went to the event that when she lit the candles, they weren't staying lit and they wasn't smelling up the room and it wasn't exactly what she ordered. And I didn't understand that because if you, like, I have reviews, I have, my candles are sold out. Like, she's my only complaint. My candles are sold out. And the only difference is, Jerry, I can be honest and admit, this particular batch that I made for her, I didn't use as much oil as I did with the first candles because I just started and I was experimenting when I started, when I made my sample candles, when I gave it to her. So this particular batch that I made, I only use 1 ounce of oil per pound of wax. So apparently, when she went to her event, she said she couldn't, out of all 250 candles, it's a rose petal smell. She couldn't smell the candle throughout the whole event. She said that they wasn't staying lit. And I guess I just didn't understand it. So I asked her, well, if the candles are bad, just give them back to me, ship them back to me, and then I'll remake your order for you. She didn't want that. She wanted all her money back. And I honestly don't understand it because I've never got a complaint from my candles. All my customers, they give me good reviews. I make different flavors, glitter candles. She's the only person that I've ever had that gave me that said my candles were bad. And I don't understand how 250 are bad, but I did make it.
You never had to refund before?
I have refunded before. I have. I had a customer, his shipment didn't come.
Oh, okay.
And I refunded him, and then I sent him a few samples. I didn't send because he ordered some candles from me and it never came. I did give him a refund.
Okay, but you never refunded because they weren't happy with the quality.
I refunded because he didn't get his order.
The candle that is right in front of me here, is this the candle that you sent to the plaintiff?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
And I believe I sent you a lavender candle. It wasn't the lavender one, but the pink one that you have, yes, that's the exact kind of candle she ordered for her event, Your Honor.
Yeah, it is getting a lot of, it's getting waxy. I mean, there's a lot of liquid. I don't even know what you call
these
things.
And you know, Your Honor, it takes a lot. Yeah. It was very hard. It was a lot of labor making 250 candles.
Okay.
So I kind of expect, I understand she's upset about her business, but I kind of feel like she could have a little bit more empathy towards me because I did try to help her by doing this event.
I'm going to try to be fair here.
And I do apologize.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
Friendship has nothing to do with business.
If someone samples something and says, I want to buy this product, and then the product they get sent is a little bit different, that's not the product they agreed to pay for. So that, in business, that is a substantial factor. And because you changed the formula of the candle, that serves as a breach of the agreement. I fine for the plaintiff $1,000. Thank you.
For the most part, I'm pretty happy with the judgment. I just hate that it had to come to this.
Never do business with friends. Never do business with friends. That's my lesson. I'm not doing no more business with no more friends. So if you my friend, we're not doing business.